This video shows how to set up a self-service cluster on Amazon EKS with Informatica Cloud Data Integration. In Cloud Data Integration, you can bring your own Kubernetes cluster to schedule your data integration jobs and enable your workloads at scale. With a self-service cluster, you have management of the cluster control plane, full access to the cluster and all components, control over the deployment, administration, and user access on the cluster. In this video, we'll create a Kubernetes cluster and a cluster node group on Amazon EKS. Generate the kubeconfig file. Update the config map to enable cluster authentication from the secure agent. Create a namespace. Configure a node label. Register the self-service cluster in data integration. And finally, run a data integration job on the self-service cluster. First, let's create a Kubernetes cluster in Amazon EKS. Here, we'll enter a name for the cluster, use Kubernetes version 1.24, then select the cluster service role that we created in IAM, and enter any tags that our organization requires. Then we'll specify the networking properties. And create the cluster. After we create the cluster, we can create a node group for data integration jobs. We'll enter a name for the node group and select our node IAM role. Then for AMI type, we'll select Amazon Linux 2 and configure the compute and scaling properties for data integration jobs. We can add a subnet to the network configuration and create the node group. Now that we've created the cluster and the node group, we can generate the kubeconfig file on the secure agent machine. To generate the kubeconfig file, we'll run the following command. Great, let's open the kubeconfig file. Then, we need to make sure that the IAM role on the secure agent machine can authenticate to the cluster. We'll update the cluster config map by running the following command. Then add the agent role under the map roles section. To verify that the agent role can authenticate to the cluster, we'll run the following command and verify that there's no unauthorized error. Then, let's create a namespace for the data integration jobs. We can also configure node labels. For example, we can set up the environment label to equal development on specific nodes in the node group. With that, we're ready to register the Kubernetes cluster as a self-service cluster in data integration. In Administrator, let's go to the Advanced Clusters page and create an advanced configuration. We'll enter a name for the self-service cluster and select self-service cluster as the cloud platform. Then we'll enter the properties for our Kubernetes cluster. We need to enter the kubeconfig file path, the kubeconfig context name, and the Kubernetes cluster version. Then we'll enter the namespace that we created. Now, specify the same minimum and maximum number of nodes that we use to create the node group in the Amazon EKS console. And we can specify folder paths on Amazon S3 where we want to store the staging data and log files that the integration jobs generate. Next, we can configure node selector labels to run data integration jobs only on cluster nodes that have the environment label set to production, so that we can submit data integration to specific cluster nodes. We can also perform additional configurations like annotations and tolerations. Then save the advanced configuration. Let's run a data integration job on the cluster to verify that the job is successful. In data integration, we'll open a mapping in advanced mode and run the mapping. We can see that the job ran successfully. And that's it. For more information, see the Advanced Clusters Guide on the Informatica documentation portal, visit our communities and support hubs, or check out our website.